There you are. Aaron went down in the third. Clients are happy. Love to see plans work out. Scratch, you were promised. Here.
Aaron, what awaits him?
He's our guy. We'll take care of him. Guess he thought he could get rid of the chip and the past. But that just ain't how it works. I think he understands that now.
You know what, Angie? Giving it some thought. You keep the scratch. In exchange, get that fucking chip out of his head.
Touching. But you earned it. Every last ed. Take it. As for the chip, we'll think on it. Maybe once Aaron proves he'll behave, deserves our trust. Till then, we like having the option.
Thank you.
Hang on. Gotta go.
Not gonna lie, V. You got a gift. Thanks for the help, V. My chum will do the finishing touches. Little token of my appreciation's waiting for you in the drop locker.
Thank you. yesterday we completed some necessary repairs to the hospital. 2 months of hard work have been hard to pay. Starting today, the hospital and its staff have been operating under hostile protection. Any conditions? A new leg? Report directly to Dr. Robertson. That'll be all.
A nice place, so play nice, hear me? Got our eyes everywhere.
almost every day. We get all kinds of traffic in here, from peeps looking to settle their biz in peace and quiet. Not many sides us can offer that.
I'd love to see what you got.
All kinds of good stuff. Take a look.
Isn't V. V, my favorite merc. Splendid. What you completed for me significantly shifted the playing field vis-a-vis Hanson. Excellent work, precisely as requested.
Maybe the one thing I didn't expect, to see the man behind the hollow curtain. The elusive Mr. Hans in the flesh.
Not only did you rescue those clowns in blue, you also managed to eliminate Dodger. Calm, collected, and professional. Bravo. You have proven to be a person I can trust, hence my decision to drop the veil and meet in person. A rare occurrence, I assure you. Were I to have more virtuosos like you, I wager I'd have more than Dogtown in my grasp. Dogtown, Pacifica, then I'd line up the rest, snort, and it'd be done. Working with bona fide professionals, positively a treat.
Gigs you had me do. How will they solve your Hanson sitch?
Take a boxer. He can't knock out his opponent. What then? He goes to work on the body. Once his adversary's stamina wanes, he looks for his opening, connects fists with jaw. I know it may not seem all that clear from where you stand, but the gigs you have completed will allow me to audaciously shift some of the pawns and figures on the chessboard that is Dogtown. Checkmate is but a few moves away.
Take it you prefer Dogtown with no Hanson at the helm.
Hanson wields much power, greedily so. He's also clever. These traits I tolerate, even value, when occurring in isolation. But all at once? No. Especially not in one who grips an entire district in the palm of his hand. It makes business trying. Interest you in some tea? It's my own blend.
Sure, why not?
So, how did this combat zone become Dogtown? Do you know?
Heard this and that. Something to do with the war?
2069. Colonel Hansen led an operation colorfully called Midnight Storm. The objective? To occupy this combat zone and establish an NUSA staging ground in Night City. Soon after, the sides agreed to a ceasefire. Hansen's force was left to fend for itself. Headquarters, the public, everyone feigned ignorance, pretending Hansen and company were never here. But our good colonel decided to put down roots. He declared this combat zone an NUSA territory. In our terms, he carved out an enclave for himself and went from soldier to arms dealer overnight. Marooned he was. 2 weeks for a bullet to reach his brain, everyone thought. But his brain remained intact, and he became a force to be reckoned with. A man whose existence is a threat to many is a dangerous man indeed.
Let's table politics for now, huh? Go straight to biz.
Business. Of course. The Black Sapphire. Hansen's stronghold, guarded by elite soldiers. Military quarters are situated on lower levels, while top floors are a decadent haven for the ultra-rich. The building's blueprint was not easily procured, I should say. Hansen guards his hotel secrets as if they were an embarrassing rectal itch. But given a will, ways are usually found. You help a client of mine, they reciprocate, and I gain latitude. Quid pro quo in full effect. The building plans are yours. I'll even throw in vulnerabilities to watch for, a token of my appreciation. And, though this goes without saying, the data, its source, are completely secure. No one knows you have it. Data leaks, or lack thereof, are the difference between myself and, say, the late Mr. Deshawn. The Shard. Black Sapphire info and blueprints, all nooks and crannies. I trust it's all you need to waltz in and perform your planned pirouettes. Yet a word of caution. Even fully prepared, you'll be marching into a pit full of vipers. Watch your step.
Thanks, Hans.
I only hope this won't mark the end of our collaboration. Truth be told, a few new assignments seem imminent.
Let me guess. More local politico gaming?
Activity is abundant in Dogtown, and behind closed doors, plots and schemes. Should change ever occur, as it inevitably must, someone really ought to pave the way for a smooth transition.
Be looking forward to those new gigs, then.
You will hear from me soon. This, I guarantee you. And V, whatever happens at the Black Sapphire, make sure you come back alive, You're going where local and international politics mix. Strong currents, both.
Make sure to plant my feet firmly, then. Later, Hans. Reed, got the data shard from Hans. Our golden ticket into the Black Sapphire.
Perfect. Send it to him. No worries. This connection's secure.
Catch. It's on its way.
And reception complete. I'll pass it on to Alex. And as soon as you're ready, join us at the Moth. If I'm not there when you arrive, just wait. Till then.
There's a job, V. A journalist, Bree Whitney, has fled into Dogtown. I need you to look after her.
She fled? Means I gotta keep her tucked away?
No. Bree has a lead. You're to help her complete her investigation. There's a corp on her tail, as she put it. That is all she said. Miss Whitney seems to have some minor trust issues.
Right. So where am I meeting this mystery-insistent woman?
You'll go to her apartment first, on Skyline West. You're to collect an electronic access card. And no, do not say this card, what's it open? I simply don't know. Contact me once this is sorted. You'll learn more details then.
Thank you. Take a moment. Think of these words. was in her room night after night?
What a fucking mess.
It's like the place is rough.
Finger on the trigger, V.
Sit your ass down and shut your mouth. Need to think.
I need to like get my fucking nails stuck. The studio will make you pay for this.
Lena Molina, she around?
I am Lena Molina, queen bitch of Dogtown. Listen, get me out of here and I'll let you take me out to dinner. Maybe.
Guess it's your lucky day.
Hey, sweet cheeks, eyes up. Stare at my tits long enough. Bash this asshole in the head and take me home.
Put a sock in it, dumbass. Gonk in the boots, my friend, and a partner. Tool.
And here I thought we had a fucked up partnership.
Let's go upstairs before he gets too riled up. I'll explain everything.
This is gonna be good. I can feel it.
Jesus Christ.
Fuck! I should be scrolling! You're thanking my soul! My fucking life! Mark my words, asshole. My boys will find me. They'll bust me out of this shithole.
Tool's been a diehard fan of Lena since the beginning. Relives all her BDs. This being Dogtown, a few days ago we had a power surge. BD Reith was pulling juice while Tool was, well, being Lena. BD got stuck in his head, sizzled his synapses. Ever since then, he thinks he's the real Lena Molina. Talks like her, acts like her, the whole works. Figuring as you're already a witness to this whole mess, might have a job for you.
Your chum needs a ripper, stat. Take it you want to get him some help?
No need. Tool will get back to normal in no time. Since you're here. Willing to pay top eddies if you can help with a little something. It's about capitalizing on the present state of affairs. Catch my drift?
I don't, no.
Look, store's barely staying afloat. Nobody's buying our squirrels and Hansons, bleeding us dry in rent. Yeah, heads, Nova. Catches your eye. But let's not kid ourselves. Folks in Dogtown ain't ample of the wallet.
Deep in the land of Nod. And yet I'm running naked through wet streets. I'm in Pacifica and being chased.
Your chum loses touch with reality and you're angling to make a quick Euro buck?
Oh, please. Don't need a Merc lecture in me on ethical biz practices. Gotta stay and keep an eye on Tool. Make sure he doesn't off himself or break something. You go get Lena and bring her here for a BD shoot. We'll do a collab. Call it Double Gang Bang. Lena gets content for an episode. Store's rep gets a boost from her fans. Win, win.
Big lidless eyes staring back. Freak me the fuck out. So, any and I are critics out there want to shed some light on this shit show of a dream? Get in touch. I'm hella curious. Craving another fix of fresh finds? Here's another batch.
You glitching out on me?
Afraid Tool might stay this way forever?
Nah, he'll be fine. Sometimes peeps go a little wackadoodle post-virtue. Trust me, I've seen it all. More worried about those Barkist pricks coming to collect. Cause right now, we're making as much as a joy toy with erectile dysfunction.
Okay, I'll get Lena down here. Just need her address.
Sent. If we scroll something preem, I'll throw in a little extra.
Sounds like a bulletproof plan. What could go wrong? Who's this Lena chick anyway?
She scrolls BDs. Gonzo content in sparkly packaging. Runs with a gang, fucks DJs, snorts designer drugs, and tears up the streets in tricked out rides while squirting lead out the window.
Ought to help this poor gawk, not scrolling like some zoo animal.
What would you do?
Talk to a ripper, or someone who knows a thing or two about virtues?